share just a short message with us tonight. Amen. It is Palm Sunday. Hallelujah. This is the day that Jesus made his triumphal entry into Jerusalem. Hallelujah. And just started this holy week that we're going to celebrate all week long. Amen. We're so glad that you're here with us tonight. Amen. Let's welcome all of our visitors tonight. Let's give them a hand clap. Amen. And we are expecting another powerful move of the Holy Spirit tonight. Amen. The Spirit of God moved in here this morning. And I tell you what a phenomenal service we had today. Amen. The King is coming is what I ministered on this morning. But I'm so excited, amen, to see what God is going to do in this service tonight. Amen. So let's thank Brother John.
Says, but God commandeth his love toward us, in that, while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. You know, as I'm sitting at home this morning, my flesh kept me home in bed, missed church. So, the Holy Spirit got on me, and I started weeping. And I started thinking how thankful I am for the Lord, for what he's done for me this week, as we're going to go through the events that's going to happen, and all the torture and everything he did for me. I'm thankful for him. I'm thankful for the blood, the cross. So as a brother today, no matter what the world might take and send your way, you know, he died for you.
Yes.
He died for you.
Come on.
You, Brother Billy. So just remember that, you know, no matter what the world, the flesh, or anything out here this week is going to bring to you, you know, Christ died for you.
That's right.
So, Pastor, that's the message I want to bring today. You know, this world is nothing. You know, he's died for us, and that's the only thing that matters.
Amen.
So, turn around and greet your neighbor tonight. Shake your hand and help your neighbor. Tell them you're glad to save in the house of the Lord. The Lord will sing to the prayer. We're going to ask his blessings upon this evening worship service. And we're going to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords tonight. Amen. Precious Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you, Lord, this evening, Lord, as we step into your house. God, just as your word said that we need to enter in with thanksgiving, God, we thank you right now, Lord, for sending your only begotten Son, Lord, to this cruel world, Lord, that we may have life and that more abundantly. God, we thank you, Lord, right now, Lord, for just giving us another opportunity to be in your house. Lord, on Palm Sunday, Lord, we've come to celebrate, Lord, this day, because we know, Lord, that without the blood of your Son, Lord, that we would be most lost tonight. God, we thank you, God, right now. Lord, as we enter in your courts, we enter in with praise upon our lips. God, we're going to praise you with song. God, we're going to praise you with offerings. Lord, we just thank you tonight. We glorify your name. We lift you up and magnify you, God. Lord, have your way in our midst. Lord, lift up every heart in this building. Lord, encourage you, Lord God, just right now. Lord, edify them, Lord, to the uttermost. Lord, just give us the strength, Lord God, to go out, Lord, and fight this enemy, Lord God, that keeps you pressing against us. Lord, we know that we're more than conquerors, Lord, through the blood of Jesus tonight. God, we just worship you. God, we praise you. Lord, we lift you up and magnify your name. Hosanna! Hosanna! Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah! Come on, give the Lord a good shout of praise. Amen.
Hallelujah. Come on, church.
just going to receive our tithes and offerings this evening. Saints of God, most of you may or may not know, but giving and tithing is another way that we praise and worship God. Amen. And I'm so glad for your faithfulness tonight in doing so. Amen. And we just want to say thank you from the bottom of our heart. Amen. Because it's about your tithing and your giving. Amen. It makes all these ministries possible. Hallelujah. That reaches outside of these four walls. Amen. And reaches the lost with that gospel message of hope. Hallelujah. And salvation. So we thank you tonight. Amen. All of you that are ready to tithe and give, I want you to take out your seed offering tonight. We're going to ask a good prayer over it this evening. Amen. And we're going to believe God because the Bible says that the Lord is our Jehovah Jireh, which means He is our provider. Hallelujah. Amen. The Bible says that He will supply all of our needs according to His riches and glory. Amen. So we are going to ask the Lord tonight, amen, not only to corporately meet the needs of His church, amen, but we're going to ask God to individually meet the needs of His people tonight. The Bible says that He knows our needs before we ask, but we're going to ask Him. Hallelujah. So let's bow our heads tonight. Dear precious Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you, Lord, for this service. God, we thank you for these phenomenal and wonderful songs, Lord God, that have been an uplift and encouragement to our soul. God, we thank you right now, Lord, that you bless, Lord God, the saints to be able to give back into your kingdom. Lord, and I know that right now, Lord, as they release this seed and they do it by faith, in faith believing in the word and the blood of Jesus right now, Lord, as this seed falls in this fertile ground here at Oasis, God, that you're going to bless the seed and increase it, and God, it's going to produce a harvest, Lord, not only corporately for the church, for souls, for the labor, Lord God, that this house would be full. That's your desire. That's what your word says. But God, I'm believing individually tonight, Lord, your word said that there would be some 30-fold, some 60-fold, and some 100-fold blessings. But God, as they're obedient to you, amen, and they bring their tithe into the storehouse tonight, they bring their love offering to you, God, I know that you're going to be faithful and you're going to meet every need, spiritually, physically, and financially. Lord, that 100-fold harvest and blessing is coming. In Jesus' name, amen, and we all say hallelujah. Amen. God bless you tonight as you give. Amen. I'm going to ask Brother Chad Fitch if he would come tonight. Amen. And my mother, if she would come tonight, we're going to do an old song. Hallelujah. That was written and composed in 1971. It's called The Lighthouse. Hallelujah. We love this song. We love the message in this song because Jesus is still the lighthouse tonight. Amen. And I believe that if you are lost, you are undone. Amen. All you've got to do is find that lighthouse tonight. Amen. Jesus will save you. He'll lift you up out of the miry clay. Hallelujah. He'll set your feet on that solid rock. Hallelujah. Amen. I don't know about you tonight, saints, but I don't know where I'd be if I didn't have that rock that the builders rejected. Hallelujah. I thank Jesus tonight for all He's done for me and my family. I thank Jesus for what He's done for the church. I thank Jesus, amen, for what He's doing right now. The Bible said where two or three are gathered, and He would be right here in the midst. I feel Him in this house. I feel Him in this place. I feel the presence of the Holy Ghost in this house. Hallelujah. You want to stand and just give the Lord a good wave of and a praise tonight. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, I'm thankful for the lighthouse. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Ooh, yes. There's a lighthouse on the hill.
You know, this morning while I was working, this lady sent me a message on Facebook Messenger. She asked me to pray for her nephew. Yeah. And there's a whole lot of things that's going on with this young man. He was hurt in a logging accident down in West Virginia about 8 or 9 days ago. And it's a lot easier to tell you what's not wrong with him than to tell you what's wrong with him. And you know, I could hear in this, even through this text message that this lady sent me, I could hear the desperation in her voice. And it made me realize something, that we have a hope. We can go to the Lord anytime. But there's people that don't know, don't have that. That's something that sometimes I believe, even myself, that we take for granted. And you know, and the Lord started stirring me after this message, and I walked out back of the plant, and I started praying for this gentleman on my break at this morning. And you know, God really just took over, and I just felt a stirring in my spirit, but I felt an ease come over me, and I know God heard my prayer. And you know what? This song says it all, and I every one of us can relate to the words that's in this song, so y'all pray for me.
Hallelujah. If you would stand with me all over the Lord's house as we're turning there this evening.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So glad he's in the house tonight.
Amen.
Mark's Gospel, chapter 11. Hallelujah. Whenever you get there, just shout amen.